Welcome to the first episode of BioVidyalaya. Main aim of this channel is to discuss topics of biology, mainly some important topics from the syllabus of CSIR NET Life Science Examination. I am Chitra. This is something about me. I am a graduate in biotechnology from MG University, Kerala. I am a postgraduate in bioinformatics from Bharathidasan University, Tamil Nadu. In this video, I am going to discuss about CSIR JRF NET Life Science exam. I am mainly going to discuss about the pattern of exam, mark distribution, syllabus, and study plan. Next. The first one is pattern of CSIR NET Life Science exam. The duration of exam is 3 hours, that is 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. The question paper is divided into 3 parts, Part A, Part B and Part C. Part A mainly consisting of general aptitude question, that is logical reasoning, graphical analysis, analytical and numerical ability, quantitative comparison, series formation, puzzles, etc. Part B, subject related, direct questions. Part C, subject related, mainly analytical question, we have to apply our scientific knowledge. Okay. Next is mark distribution. For part A, total number of questions 20. You can answer maximum 15 questions and you will get 2 marks for every right answer. For part B, total number of questions 50 and you can answer maximum 35 questions, out of which you will get 2 marks for every right answer. And part C, total number of 75 questions and you can answer maximum 25 questions and you will get 4 marks for every right answer. For part A total, you will get 30 marks and for part B, you will get 70 marks and part C, you will get maximum 100 marks. But that means total 200 marks. There is a negative mark, that is 25% for every wrong answer. Or 25% means for part A, that is 0.5, and part B minus 0.5, and part C, that is 1 mark for every wrong answer. Okay. Next important thing is you should have an idea about how many mark minimum required to clear JRF. Here, minimum mark required to clear JRF is 120 out of 200, that is 60%. But this 60% is not a fixed mark. It will vary every year. This is an approximate mark only. Next, avoid negative marking. 0.5 for every wrong answer in part A and part B and 1 mark for every wrong answer in part C. Okay. So, it is very important to avoid negative mark. Okay. Next, see this table. I think from this table you will get an idea about how the negative mark will affect your total score. See here. In, suppose, this is an example only, suppose in part A, you attended 5 questions, all are correct only, so you will get 10 marks, okay. In part B, you attended 22 questions, out of which 20 correct answer, 2 incorrect answer, then you will get minus 1, okay. Part C, you attended 20 questions, out of which 18 correct answer, 2 incorrect answer. Then you will get minus 2. See here, 2 incorrect answer in part B, that is 2
negative mark 0.5. Okay, 0.5 is the negative mark. That means 1 mark for 2 incorrect answer. Negative 1 for 2 incorrect answer. Okay. In part C, you had 2 incorrect answer. Then 2 into 1. That is 2 into 1. That is 2 marks. Okay. Minus 2 marks. Then total score 119. That means minus 3. See here. If there is no negative mark, means you will get 122. Because of this negative mark, that is minus 3, only you get 190. I think now you get an idea about how this negative mark will affect your total score. Yes, we can go to next time. Okay.
Syllabus of CSIR Life Science exam. There are total 13 units. Unit 1, molecules and their interaction relevant to biology. Unit 2, cellular organization. Unit 3, fundamental process. Unit 4, cell communication and cell signaling. Unit 5, developmental biology. Unit 6, system physiology plan. Unit 7, system physiology animal. Unit 8, inheritance biology. Unit 9, diversity of life forms. Unit 10, ecological principle. Unit 11, evolution and behavior. Unit 12, applied biology. Unit 13, methods in biology. Total 13 units is there, but no need to study all the 13 units. As I told, you can select at least 7 to 8 units and study that thoroughly. You only decide which are the units you are going to study, because you only know that which are the subject you know, which are the subject you are familiar with, and which are the subject you didn't study yet. So you can select at least 7 to 9 units. Okay. Suppose you are from zoology background. You didn't study biochemistry yet. So it is better to skip that unit 1, that is biochemistry unit only. Otherwise, if you are familiar with the biochemistry, means you can study that subject. Otherwise, you can select some of the important topics from that unit 1 and study. Okay. If you are not familiar with subject, means it is better to skip that unit. Don't waste time for that unit. Same time you can study other units. Okay. So unit 1 it is important. Unit 2 it is important. Unit 3 important. Unit 4 important. Unit 5 important. Unit 6 easy, and it is important unit only. Unit 7 if you want you can skip. If you know the subject, means you can study. Otherwise you can skip. Unit 8 it is important. Unit 9 if you know the subject, means you can study. Otherwise you can skip, no problem. Unit 10 it is important. Unit 11 important. Unit 12 important. Unit 13 it is also important. From unit 13, questions are mainly asking like combined question with molecular biology. So it is better to study unit 13, and if you want, you can select some of the important topic from that unit and study. Okay. I think now you get an idea about that syllabus. These are some reference book for CSIR NET Life Science examination. This is unit wise only. If you want, you can pause the video and note it down. Next important thing is study plan. You should make a study plan. First, You start preparation 4 to 5 months before the examination date. Study 5 to 6 hours every day. Select minimum 7 to 8 units that is sufficient to crack JRF, but you should study that 7 to 8 units thoroughly. Prepare short notes on each topic that will help you for the quick revision. Do revision every weekend. Solve maximum previous year question papers and mock tests. If you search in Google, you will get previous year question paper and link for mock test. Be positive, that is very important. I hope it will help you people. Best of luck.
Thank you.